This video takes a look at how you do regression and stepwise regression with the SPC for Excel software. With regression, what you're trying to do is to find out if a response variable, in this case delivery time, is impacted by one or more predictor variables, in this case number of cases and distance. This is some data from Douglas Montgomery's book on Introduction to Regression Analysis. What you do is you enter your data into an Excel spreadsheet, then you select the data, and you go to regression on the SPC for Excel menu. And you have two types, regression and stepwise regression. We're going to start with regression. You have some options with regression. Those are what sort of residuals you want. We're just going to go with the basic ones we have here, standardized and internally and externally studentized residuals. You can do leverage, Cook distance, etc., but we'll just stay with the basics. You select OK and select OK, and you quickly generate your output for the regression analysis. This is how simple and quick it is to do a regression analysis in the SPC for Excel. Now let's take a look at the output that you get. You come to the summary sheet, and on the summary sheet you have the regression model, delivery time as a function of number of cases and distance. You have an ANOVA table for the model. The key thing here is the p-value less than 0.05? If it is, the model is significant, and in this case it is, and it's turned to red by the software package. And then we have the predictors table. We have our intercept, number of cases and distance. We have our coefficient. Then we have some statistical information as well as those p-values. Again, if it's less than 0.05, it's statistically significant, and all of them are in this case, and they're all red. You also have your variation and inflation factors, which help you look at multicollinearity and your standardized coefficients to figure out which one has a bigger impact. Then you have your regression statistics, things like R-squared, the standard error, the Durbin-Watson statistics, and at the bottom we have our predictor, where you can predict results based on the model. So come in, let's say we were going to deliver 30 cases and we had to walk 500 in feet and distance. We can predict what the time is going to be. It's going to take us 58 minutes, and we have 95 confidence intervals around the mean as well as the predicted value. So this is a summary page for our regression output. Now let's take a look at the residual sheet that comes out. In the residual sheet, what we do is we have our observation number, observed value, predicted value. Then we have the raw residuals. And then it has the residuals that we selected to use. In this case, we were just using standardized, internally studentized, and externally studentized. And anything in red is a potential outlier. In this case, we have two things in red. It says this observation 9 is a potential outlier. And the definition of a potential outlier is down in the notes at the bottom of the page. Now, also with the regression, we get two regression charts automatically. We get a normal probability plot of the residuals, and this is the raw residuals. Straight line means it's a good normal probability plot. And then we have the predicted values versus the observed values, and you want those, of course, to follow along the straight line. Now we can make some changes to the regression analysis as well. Back on the residuals page is a revise button. You select the revise button, and here's some things you can do. We can add additional residual charts. If I select that option, it comes up. We can select the residual that we had. And then do we want a normal plot of it, a histogram, a plot versus the observation number versus predicted value? If I did standardized residuals, selected the histogram and the residuals versus the observation number, select OK. And what we have are the new charts added over on the regression chart page. Here's the histogram I wanted, and here's the residuals versus the observation number. We can also come back and you can remove observations. For example, we know that observation 9 might be an outlier. We might want to remove it. We select OK. We would come in and select 9 and then select OK, and it would generate a new regression analysis in the workbook with observation 9 removed. We can also remove variables if we want. Come in and you can remove either number of cases or distance, or you can remove a value of based on its p-value. And finally, you can also transform the y-value. You can use a power, you can use a square root or the reciprocal square root or the logarithm or the reciprocal logarithm to transform the y-value. So you can make some changes to the regression once it's completed. Now let's take a look at how you use stepwise regression. Suppose we have a product where we're interested in measuring the taste, and we have a measure of doing that, and we have three acids that we think have an impact, acidic, H2S, and lactic, and what we want to know is if any of them really do impact taste. And we want to do a stepwise linear regression. And with stepwise linear regressions, what it does, it adds variables to a model or remove them based on certain p-values. So we select our data, again go to the SPC for Excel, regression, and here we're going to select stepwise regression. And here are the options. We have a p-value to enter, which is the default's 0.15, p-value to remove a variable is 0.15, and then you can run the full analysis with the variables that are left in the model. Note we have three variables we're trying to put in the model right now. So we select OK. Come back and select OK, and we get our output. And what you'll do is you'll get the same regression output as we've already discussed, but you also get an extra sheet called Stepwise, and this tells you what happened. In the first step, you added H2S, and this was the best thing to add, and this is the model at this point. In step two, you added lactic, and you can see this is the results at this point now with H2S and lactic in it. But the acetic acid never had a value of P less than 0.15, so it was never added to the model. And then you come back and you can see here we just have H2S and lactic. So what it does is it goes through stepwise, enters the variables that give you the best fit model, and then generates the summary results as here. So this is how you do stepwise regression with the SPC for Excel software. Thank you for watching the video.